Aloha, it's Matthew. I have a second take on October's Manny by Me kit. I had started talking a video back about how I was going to get every kit for a year for the Manny by Me kit. But I didn't finish the thought because the idea was that you can pause your subscription. If you subscribe to it and you see a kit coming up on their announcement day that you just don't think you like, you can pause or skip that month. But I was going to try and do... This was the gnome month. And personally, I'm just not that into gnomes. But there's a lot of other fall-themed stuff on here. And so... I'm going to do a second take today with no gnomes. So I'm trying to give a different approach here that, like, if you saw it on the release date and you thought, ew, gnomes, not for me. I'm trying to show that they're very versatile. They have quite a bit of other stuff, too. It's not just gnomes. So I started some... I finally got my birthday polish from Hollow Taco. I picked the light link. And the reason I didn't have it on the other day and I was complaining was because I didn't realize it came with the brush I don't like. And now I can't seem to find it. I was gonna show you guys the bottle. Well, I know it's here somewhere because I literally just painted my nails with it. But anyway, it's the light link from their light multi-chrome collection. Huh. That's weird. Oh well, I'm sure I'll find it right when I stop recording. Okay, well, moving on. This pink base that I did... is Shaky Alibi from the Orly Plot Twist collection, which was the fall release for 2023. We got great colors in here and massive bottles. If you guys aren't signed up for the Orly Color Pass, it's something I highly recommend. I got the Christmas one, but I'm holding off on Christmas Manny's until after Thanksgiving. I asked you guys about it, and all the responses I said, wait, do more fall stuff. So here we are. Okay. So the plates that came with the kit are MXM113 and MXM114. And they are exclusive to the Manny by Me subscription. So if you get it, if you aren't a current subscriber... and you decide you love these plates, you can subscribe and then go back and access older plates if they're still available. Okay, so I have some fall-colored stamping polishes here. This one is Artichoke, which I think came in that... that month's kit. And then this one... I did a video when I swatched out this set, and I still haven't written down the name of it. The sticker got lost from it, but it's a nice terracotta color. Then we've got Cozy, B350, Alocasia, B441. These two were in that Desert Dwellers, I think was the name of the... Maybe it was all three of these. Desert Dwellers. And then this one is B330 Boba. And, okay, let's get started. And for the biggest nail, the thumb, I'm going to go from this smorgasbord right here of, here, I'll pick it up. This one here that has a whole bunch of critters. Now, if you wanted, you could take an pick this up and then reverse stamp, like color in the bear or the fox or whatever. But I think I'm just going to... I think I'm going to do like a diagonal so that I can cover it, because this one is the biggest nail that I've got going on there. So let's do that one in the boba, which is a nice dark brown. It's got a reddish hue to it. Okay. And I should say here at the beginning, if you like nail stuff, if you like stamping, nail painting, etc., feel free to subscribe to my channel and I will bring you more videos. Plenty of polish there. Okay. I don't have a scraper card. Oh, no. Choose one. I thought I was prepared. Okay. And I'm gonna go at a diagonal like that. Yeah. Okay, there's that fun woodland creatures with little branches and stuff. And I think that that dark brown on this pinky tan nudish colored base is nice, good and striking. Okay, sorry about that panic, I didn't have a card. Okay, and then for this next nail, I want to do the, I thought I had it picked out. Yeah, let's do this one. This one here is, another one kind of like that. Here, let me pull it up close so you can see. Bunnies and hedgehogs and leaves and woodland critters. And that one I'm gonna do in the artichoke. This color, you guys, it's kind of deceiving in it when you look at it in the bottle. I've put it on like a pumpkin orange and it looked stellar. I've put it on a dark chocolate brown and it looked amazing. This is a really good, very good duochrome color. And although this one came in the kit, the polishes are not exclusive to the kits. So those will come to the site later. So this one's probably already on the site since this was from, I'm pretty sure this was October's kit. Mm-hmm. Okay. And up. And then we're gonna go, I'm trying to get it so you can see. Right there. And I'm just gonna put a little boop of a mushroom there on the tip. Okay. My little hedgehog didn't quite get a full body, but that's okay. Can you see that color? It's like this golden green. It's really stunning. You see it catch on that leaf right there? At the end here, we'll zoom in on all the nails so you can look at them in more detail. Okay, so I do love this leaf gathered up here. And for that one, I'm going to use the No Gnome terracotta one. I'll look up the name and I'll put it in the description when I post the video. Sorry, I should have looked it up beforehand. All right. And I didn't clean off any of my stampers. All right, you guys. I'm just getting ahead of myself. Okay, let's clean this up. And let's clean that up. Just too excited to get the stamp on the nail. So I was trying to look for anything that might look good on my nails to add to this, but they're really like a green, blue, turquoisey, summertime, springtime color. They're not really fall. And I just couldn't tie anything in with them. And so I'm just gonna stamp on the tips today. Nothing on my actual fingernails. I guess I could have pulled out a... Ooh, maybe I'll think about it and think about pulling out a different plate while we're working on these ones. Okay, so let's clean this up here and try again. Okay. Where were we? Okay, no name, terracotta on this nail. I've used this stamp before when I did those chocolate brown nails. And I think, I mean, you could follow your heart and do whatever you want, but I think it looks best if you put it at the cuticle side. Like, oh, can you see? Like this. And then you leave the rest of the nail open. Yeah. It kind of gives this like false French tip, because all this area that's not got a pattern is almost like a tip being left open. You know what I mean? Okay. I got two more nails here, and I'm going to use this mix. This one's got, come on, focus. This one has ferns and mushrooms and acorns, but it's all kind of like, where this one's random, this one's all centralized on that one mushroom in the middle. So I'm going to go for that one. And that one I'm going to do in the gold cozy. Yeah, cozy B350. Okay, I've got clean stampers. Okay. Clean stampers. And oh yeah, I forgot this one was really thick the last time I used it. I think it could use a couple drops of nail polish thinner. Oh. Well, that didn't pick up at all. I wonder if it's because it's so thick. It is like 85, 86 degrees today. I keep telling you guys that it doesn't feel like fall. It doesn't feel like fall. It's really hot outside. We finally got some rain, though. The trade winds that are often, almost always blowing here had stopped for a little while. And it got really hot, really dry. And I'm giving up on that pattern, and I'm going for these pumpkins. And what I'm going to do with the pumpkins is some reverse stamping. Let me grab. I have my detail brush here. And this came as one of the free gifts in the, I think this was the September Manny by Me kit. And then I've got this SE, what's it called? Make No Concessions. And it's like a shimmery pumpkin red, orange. And so I'm going to pull up the pumpkins with boba and then color them in with this. So let's do that. Put down the boba. Mm-hmm. Okay. Got a nice clean pick up there. Can you see up there? You can see better with no hand. Okay. Let's get that plucked off. Okay. So then I've got this piece of tape over here from what I was using earlier, and I will just drop a dollop of this paint right there. And it's painting these pumpkins. Okay. Probably gonna need some more since that all just landed on my tape dispenser. So I'm doing this this No Gnome version. Let me know in the comments if you'd like me to do an all gnome version. I can come back on Friday and pull out these same plates and do one that's all gnomes if you guys want. Otherwise, I have another idea for Friday. Okay. I'm just kind of plopping that on pretty thick. Went outside the lines just a wee bit there. Okay, let's take a look from this side. And I need some more right up top there. And then on both outer. Both outer edges like that. Okay, yeah, that looks good. I'm just gonna let that set aside for a second and dry. And clean up my brush here. This had acetone on it from cleaning my plate there. Just brush it out of the bristles. Okay. And then we just have one last nail. And this one, I think I want to do I was thinking about the sunflowers. I'm trying to do something in this gold that I could move quick enough, and I might just, let's give it a shot. Let's give the sunflowers a shot and see if this gold will pick it up. And I'm going to do the same kind of thing. I'm just trying to move really fast here. Okay, so we are going to scrape and pick up. Got it. Okay. And I'm going to do the same kind of thing with where this is going on the nail as what I did with the other one, like closer to the base of the nail or where the cuticle would be. Yeah. I know there's a lot of reflection in that, so you probably can't see any of it, any of the detail, but like I said, we'll zoom in here and take a look at everything in just a moment. That last this reverse stamp pumpkin is not quite dry. So let's zoom in and take a look at the other ones, and then we can stamp that last one, and then we'll be done. Okay, I'm gonna zoom in real quick. All right, so here are those woodland creatures. And like I said, you could take, if you wanted to center this one around the owl, or let's say center the whole stamp around the fox, you could reverse paint in the one main one and then just leave the rest of them open if you wanted. There is that artichoke. That color is sensational. Look at that shift. I am mesmerized by that one. And aside from this little hedgehog having a missing body, it's a pretty good stamp. I didn't see it on the stamper beforehand. If I were doing it on my reel, on my hand, on my nails, hopefully I would have looked at the stamper beforehand to make sure. And if it really bothered you that much, you could pull the stamp again and isolate everything out except for that little hedgehog, and then just, boop, add him right on top. And then here are those leaves done in that terracotta, the no-name terracotta. And then here are those, there we go. You see those golden sunflowers? They look really good on that pinky brown base. Yeah, there's a good shot of it. So there's a shot where you can see the detail, and then there you can see how lustrous that color is. Okay, so now let's zoom back out. Okay, so in order to make this one stick, I'm gonna use some Orly Bonder base. Maniology has their own, they have a sticky base coat. And so if you're ordering from them, you can just get the sticky base coat. If you already have Orly Bonder base, they perform the same in this particular task, where I'm just gonna put a little bloop right down the middle of the nail there. The idea is that you've got a dry nail and a dry stamp. You need something to make them stick together, right? And so they instruct 30 seconds. Let this dry until it's about tacky, 30 to 45 seconds. And for me currently, 30 seconds is probably too much just because it's so hot here right now. And I'm gonna make the pumpkin stack face the people that are gonna see it versus the owner of the nail. And we're gonna do it like that. Okay. Now if this were on my nail, I would have taken a wee bit more time and tried to not go out of the lines there. But again, if someone sees this on your nail, they're just gonna love the little pumpkin image. They're gonna see that it's a pumpkin. They're not gonna snatch up your fingers and point out that you went outside the lines right there. It's just not gonna happen. Most other people don't look as closely at our nails as we do, I think, or at least as I do, you know. Other people just see them and they like them, and that's the end of the story. Okay, so we got that pumpkin added on. Let's take a zoomed in look at that one real quick. There we go. I see that there's that little blob that I went over the lines, but it's a fun, sparkly orange. The, SE Make No Concessions. And if you wanted to get really detailed, you could paint in, there's a leaf on each side there that you could hit with a green. But I think that the outline looks nice there with the little curlicue vines. All right, and that's what I've got for you guys today. enjoy your fall. If you celebrate it, Thanksgiving's coming up, and look forward to spending time with family and friends. Oh yeah, I almost always forget to say, because these aren't going on my fingers or anybody's fingers that I know, so I just stop there. But if you are stamping on your nails, in order to seal off your stamping, you need to use the smudge-free top coat, which is an oil-based top coat. And when you put it on over these solvent-based polishes, it's not going to reactivate and smear, hence the name smudge-free top coat. And stamping is such a thin amount of polish that, I mean, these were dry as soon as I stamped them on. And so then putting the top coat on, you're good to go. If you feel like you still need a top coat, feel free to add a quick dry top coat on top if you want extra gloss or whatever, but that smudge-free top coat can be your ending point. And I think that's it for today. Okay, bye. Aloha, it's me again. Of course I found the bottle right as soon as I stopped filming. This is Light Link, and that's, it just looks spectacular in the sun. You get the shift between green, turquoise, blue, aqua, and then there's also a shimmer in there. Beautiful polish. Okay, bye.